Om Shri Sai Ram. Most humble pranams to the lotus feet of our most merciful beloved Bhagavan. On behalf of Chennai Metro North, we welcome you all for the live satsang series. Today, we are going to discuss on karma, bhakti, jnana, a synthesis. Our action determines our future. That describes in Karma Yoga. Having been born as a human is a very rare opportunity. After getting this noble opportunity, our ultimate aim is to realize God. So how to attain that? And we often feel that where we have been involved in this materialistic world, we feel it's not that easy to attain. Just assume those days, Gopikas, they never have knowledge, they never learned scriptures, they never learned Vedas, but their infinite love towards Krishna has made them to analyze vision, and even they could able to attain the devotion, and ultimately they can reach God. The ultimate aim of a human is to understand the pure love. So that is the infinite thing which we require to attain the jnana. To practically analyze all these things, definitely we require a practical person. Obviously, it is T.G. Krishnamurti uncle we are going to discuss on this topic. He has been in this organization from 1960 onwards, almost 60 years. And he was the senior most member of our organization, and he has been carried out in various posts in our organization. And out of Swami's infinite love and grace, and he has got physical proximity, and Swami has insisted him to undergo the Bhagavatam. So when I visited his home, I just found that uncle has written the Bhagavatam, almost it consists of 14,400 slokas. Going through the complete meaning, and he, on his own handwritten, he has made up on his notebook, almost a compilation of 20 notebooks. It is not that easy to carry out. I never seen such person in the world like this. So such an amazing person, such a fortunate person we are having today to discuss on this topic. At the end of the session, we are going to have question answers. So we have got questions across the world from many countries. So even we are going to interact on those topics also. Let us involve ourselves more seriously into this topic. Over to you, uncle. Sai Ram.
Om Sri Sai Ram. Tapasvino, Danapara, Yasasvino, Manasvino, Mantravida Sumangalaha, Shemamna Vina Vindanti Yadarpanam, Tasmai Sri Guruve Namaha. Tapasvino are great sages, Danapara philanthropists, Yasasvino are mystics, Manasvino are philosophers, Mantravida are those who chant Vedas, Sumangalaha, those who follow Vedic principles. These very important persons of the society feel their lives are not secured unless they offer their respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of our Bhagavan. While so, we, the VIPs, very insignificant persons, have been called so many times, having given an opportunity to touch his lotus feet, to listen to his discourses, to have food with him. He has given us a profusely bliss for everybody, for every devotee, imitating of his caste, creed and religion. Therefore, it is our duty to offer our most respectful obeisances unto his lotus feet. Sai Ram to you, all of you. Generally, the subject that has been given to me is karma, bhakti and jnana. People may think that I'm going to talk about karma yoga, bhakti yoga, jnana yoga. No. I'm going to talk about something which Bhagavan has told us many a times. Now, the life is, Swami also, life is compared to a mud pot. You must have seen a flower pot in Deepavali times, where so much of chemicals are kept inside, it is covered in a layer. And Deepavali time, the evening, especially in the evening when it becomes dark, we go and put a light, a fire on the top of the layer, and we get a lot of beautiful colors. Swami compares that to human body. The human body is a mud pot. And inside you see all the divine qualities. But due to your materialistic feelings, it is covered with a layer. In the result, the divinity could not come out. Therefore, you require bhakti and jnana to remove that ignorance or ignorance. Bhakti is the one who has a stick. Jnana is the fire. With that fire, if you go and put at the top of the layer burns out, then the chemicals come out with beautiful colors. That beautiful color is known as divinity. So divinity is in us. That has to bring it out with the help of bhakti and jnana. And bhakti and jnana comes out only because of the karma. Without the karma, nothing happens. I start with some examples. There is no question of talking about this theory unless we give some practical examples. A student from Madurai joins in Madras college. After joining the college, his course is over. He writes government exams and goes back to the house, goes back to Madurai. If the results came and he passed, he writes a letter to the principal. My results have come, I have passed out. Please give me the leaving certificate. And the principal replies back saying, my dear boy, that you have taken a book from library which you did not return. You brought something in the chemistry laboratory. Physics laboratory, you broke tangent galvanometer. Please go pay the necessary money for all these people, all the departments, get the receipt, then I will consider giving you a certificate. This can be, it cannot be done from Madurai. He has to come to Chennai and goes to the library. Library is on leave today. So he has to wait till next day. And he goes to the chemistry department. The principal is the head of the department is on leave. Unless he gives certificate, nobody can do. He stays for one more day. Then similarly, physics, by that time, you know what happened? Coronavirus came to him. What did he do? He has to stay in the hotel. Hotel people say, you can't go out. You have to stay here. Good food is given. Nothing can be done. You cannot go anywhere. Nobody can come to you. Now, what happened to his certificates? He has to wait till he has to go and meet the principal. So he feels, oh my God, what a terrific problem I have. So at the time, he happened to talk to another professor of the college. He said, my dear boy, you made a fundamental mistake, I say. Before you left the college, you should have gone to every department to find out whether anything due. Put all the receipts due, you pay and take all the certificates, receipts, then get back to principal, get back to your house, write a letter to the principal, here are the receipts, I paid. So please give a certificate. They would have given. Then you did not have to come to Bangalore, but Chennai. Because you refused, left everything there and went back, you have to come back. This is called prarabdha karma. Similarly, when you are going out of this body, you should leave everything and see that you are free from all the problems. What do you mean by problems? Unfulfilled desires, thoughts, and their attachments. These are all things to be given up before we leave. But when you go with this, again, as I said, you have to come back to college. The Lord says, get back. I have set you free. It's free, all this attachment. You are coming back to me with attachments. Therefore, leave those attachments. So get back. You see, generally we see in our books or in our cinemas, Yamadharmaraja says you get back. Chitragupta gives his accountant. Who is Chitragupta? His accountant. But it's not at all true. It's only cinema. Chitragupta means, based on your actions, your future form is written and kept it in a secret. That is called Chitragupta. That is called God. Most of the people mistake it as Yamadharmaraja. First of all, the accountant for him and all those things. So therefore, you have to come back to remove all those dirt that has been attached to your soul. That is called prarabdha karma. That karma is contains in a bag called sanchita karma. Swami Dhanu says, when you are puttinappudu, kantamuto karma mala veskulu puttinavu, he says. That is, when you are born with a garland called kantam, Kantamala, that you prarabdha karma as a garland. That's what he says, invisible garland. Swami said so. So similarly here, so you have to work for remove all the prarabdha karmas. But when you are in the world, when you are in the day-to-day life, you are doing some action. Every action has got a reaction. So the reaction is known as agama karma, gets you into the sanchita karma. Unless sanchita karma is free, you can't have liberation. On one side, you came with something in the bag, and life you are adding one more thing. Then where the question of how to empty? That's why Swami says, when you join the organization, go and do seva. Seva, love all, serve all. When you are doing seva and learn, make it a point to see that if somebody thanks you, you must say, thank the Lord. Don't accept the thanks from the recipient. You tell them, thank the Lord. Then what happened? The sanchita karma, your agama karma, which comes to for your reactions, will go to Swami. So nothing comes to the bag of sanchita karma. Only prarabdha karma has to be removed. And one way you are saving that nothing comes to agama, nothing comes from agama karma, all agama karma goes to God. That's why Swami says, please work for me. You consider that you are working for me. You are not working for yourself. So that is the purpose Swami always says. There is a part-time devotee, full-time devotee. Last time I think I told. If you want to be a full-time devotee, everything work is for the Lord. Every work you are for the Lord. So the result of your action goes to Swami. So you should avoid further. Now this prarabdha karma again, see, you must have seen the universities. When you get about 98% or 97%, the professor was so like the student, he gives some grace marks, make it 100. Here also, God also gives some grace marks. That is, once you are doing sanchita karma, removing one by one, he gives grace marks and makes it free. That it depends upon your actions and your love for him. So first of all, this karma, your action, as long as you have life in this body, action is inevitable. Those actions, again, God has given power of discrimination. That power of discrimination is called, man has given body, senses, mind, and buddhi. Between mind and buddhi, there is a big gap. The function of the mind is to create thoughts and ask senses to move. Senses move the body. This is called karma. This karma, according to the scriptures, called dushkarma. That means bad action. Because every action, every thought that comes to you from the mind, you should get back to buddhi for approval, whether it can do or it cannot do. Once it approves, and if you do it, it becomes satkarma. So therefore, the karma also you have to distinguish which is good, which is bad. So that power has been given to us. But 99% of our people, you know, we don't consider buddhi. We want to get some mind, some thought comes, immediately we react to it. And with the result, we have to face it. So the prarabdha karma increases. That's why we are not able to proceed further with liberation.
Now, let us have a Padyam song, which has been explained by Swami about the prarabdha karma. Swami, in his own voice, you can listen how it has been meticulously explained. Let us go through this Padyam song. Once it is over, we will continue the session. Sai Ram.
ఇంకెన్నియో చేతు అనుచూహలు అల్లి అలసిపోకు ఏ విత్తులను నాటి ఇచ్చోట నుంటివో ఆ ఫలముల నీకు అందుచుండు విత్తనం ఒకటైన వేరైన ఫలములు లభించుటది ఎట్టు సాధ్యమగును. ఎన్ని చేసిన అవి అన్ని ఎంచి ఎంచి మంచి అయినను చెడుగైన తృంచకుండా బ్రహ్మనీకించి పంపును బరువు మాల. కర్మలన్నీ చేర్చిన కంఠమాల. జన్మించునప్పుడు కంఠమాలలవేమీ కానరావు. మంచి ముత్యపు సరుల్ మచ్చునకును లేవు. ఏల్మి బంగారు దండ మెడకు లేదు. రత్నాల హారము రంజిల్లగా లేదు. పశుచల పేళ్లను కొతకలేదు. కలదు కలదొక్క మాలని కంఠమందు. పూర్వజన్మాల కర్మలు పొందుపరచి బ్రహ్మనీకించి పంపెను పరువుమాల. కర్మలన్నీ చేసిన కంఠమాల. కర్మలన్నీ చేర్చిన కంఠమాల.
Uncle, I think this song has really compiled in a meticulous way. I think it has been significantly given about Prarabdha Karma. So,
Kantamala.
About Kantamala. So let us start the discussion again. Sorry, Sairamanta.
Now, Sage Vyasa has also given so much of importance for this Bhakti and Jnana. He has given a stanza poem which I am going to tell you now. Agnata Bhagavata Dharma Mantra Vignana Samhidaha Naraste Gokara Agnaya Apibhupala Vanditaha. You may be a king of the country. Apibhupala Vandita. You may be king of the country. You may be a very VIP person of the personality of this world. Mantra Vignana Samhidaha. You may be an expert in all Vedas, prescriptive Vedas. You're able to analyze piece by piece, word by word, and tell people you're such an expert. But Agnata, if you are ignorant of Bhagavata, Ba Bhakti, Ga Granam, Va Vairagyam. Vairagyam means here practical decisions. Ta, the concept of God. If you want to understand the concept of God, you require Bhakti, you require Granam, you require power of discrimination. Then only you can understand the tattvam of God. Once you understand the concept, philosophy of God, ma mukti. So bhakti and jnana, no liberation whatsoever in this world. Therefore, it has been written 800 years ago in Bhagavatam. That's what I'm talking. So now let us come back to our subject. Now karma, I have explained to you in a brief way that every action that counts the matter. In that action, there are two things here. So the more you do, the with the humble ways. Even this karma also, which is the best karma? Another point comes in. A king has a doubt. Which is the most precious act? Who is the most precious person? Which is the most precious time? This Swami has given this in 1960s example, this particular story. So nobody could give an answer to the king. And king was not satisfied. One day on a new moon day, he went for a hunting, and his ark was galloping too fast. He was a little far away from the army. He got into the forest. So he lost the army people. He was alone in the dark, scratches from the body because of the trees, and there was no light, completely dark. He did not know what to do, how to get out of this place. He left the horse, let the horse go according to his choice. After some time, he saw a light in some place. Oh, here is somebody. So he went to the particular place. He saw an old man pouring water to the plant. He got out from the horse. So the old man saw, oh, my dear man, you are too tired, you are hurt. Please come. I will give some medicines for you. And he gave some medicines all over the body. And then you are hungry. He said, yes, I am hungry. So can I give some goat milk and dry fruits? Well, so in the meanwhile, one of the disciples got hurt. So other disciples brought him to the old man. So at the time, king, my dear king, allow me to serve my disciple. Please take, here is a pillow, you take rest. He took rest. The next day morning, he was all right. He was about to take leave of the big king, leave of the old man. And he said, sir, I have some doubts, three questions, nobody has answered it. Can you answer me? What is that? Which is the most precious person? Who is the most precious person? Which is the most precious act? And which is the most precious time? He said, my dear man, you came here, I was only pouring water to your plant. You came here with full of hunger and full of damage of the body, skin. You gave me an opportunity to serve you to your satisfaction. Therefore, you are the most precious person for me. You have given opportunity. But for you, I would not have done this good act. Then yesterday, you were hungry. So I gave dry fruits, goat milk. Today, you are getting back to your palace. Tonight, I come and give the same thing to you. You keep it aside. Because in your palace, you got 7-course lunch, 7-course dinner and everything. But serving the needy is the most important act, precious act. Yesterday you did it, which is the most precious time. Whenever God gives a time to serve people, consider that as a favoritism that God has given you. Don't miss that opportunity. Wait for an opportunity to serve people. That act will give you completely out of your prarabdha karma, and prarabdha karma slowly gets down. That's why Swami says, I give grace to those people who work for others, who consider that their life is meant for others, not for themselves. So grace. What is grace? He says, I protect your prarabdha karma. According to prarabdha karma, you are supposed to have broken your leg or thigh, whatever it is. Because you are doing so much of work for others, don't do act according to your mind. Do act according to your intellect, buddhi. Then all actions are karma, satkarmas, divine acts. Divine it has got a very good result of chasing away your prarabdha karma. Okay. Now, this is action. Now, let us come to this bhakti. When we talk about bhakti, love of God, prema, Swami, prema, 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 prema. How many times? He must have told a million times about prema. He sang bhajans and prema, mujita manasukaho, prema. We also sing along with him. Love of God. We all say love of God. Do you love God? Say yes. I put that question, what do you mean by love? How do you define love? How do you explain to me what is love? 90% of the people do not know. You should have asked Swami. You know, Swami gives a beautiful example, love. Practical example is most important. A girl, a teenager girl, does she know how to take care of a child? No, she does not know because she is a teenager girl. When she is married, after 4 or 5 years, she became pregnant. She is about to deliver the child. She is almost unconscious at that time. When the child comes out of the body, the nurses take the child, washes with the, because the body consists of placenta, pus, blood, everything, umbilical cord, everything is removed, clean it, put it in a nice towel and says, this is your baby. She believes it. Any proof? No proof. But she believes it. So immediately husband is given information. Husband also believes it. Any proof? No proof. But without proof, they believe 100%. So the child, they bring the child home, put in the cradle, makes it sleep, and then the father and mother sleep in another room. In the midnight, the child all of a sudden cries. The mother immediately rushes forward, takes the child, whether hungry, gives milk, and keeps on with the baby till the baby goes to sleep. Then only she goes back to her bed. Next day morning, she comes up, takes care of the baby. Every 1 hour, drops milk, everything. And she's able to sacrifice her physical comforts for the sake of the baby. See the baby, no proof. And how do you say you may be? Faith. Faith. So you are able to sacrifice everything. At the evening, there's a function, marriage function. The husband says, let us go to the function. He says, no, I'm not coming. I have to look after the baby. I'm not coming. So he's able to satisfy so much of comforts for the sake of the baby. And the elderly people say, you eat, don't eat these vegetables, A, B, C, D, E. If you eat, then you won't get milk, sufficient milk for the baby. Even though she likes the A, B, C, D, E, she does not take it for the sake of the child. And again, they will say, these vegetables, R, S, T, E, U, V, these vegetables are very good for to get milk for the baby. Even though she does not like it, she takes it for the sake of the child. Why should you do all such things? Oh, she says, she's my baby. Any proof? No proof. That is called love. Sacrifice. Love means sacrifice. She's able to sacrifice so much. Where did she learn? Is any guru to teach her how to sacrifice? No. It is inside. It is there. God has given that soul. The soul has got one of the qualities for the divinity. Sacrifice. Love. Everything is there in the seed of divinity. That is called soul, Atma. Everything comes from our Atma for that moment. So similarly, love means here, sacrifice. And secondly, faith. What sort of faith? Unwavering faith. Unalloyed faith. There's no proof. So similarly, do you believe God? Do you believe Swami? Faith? Yes. What sort of faith you have? You have conditional faith. Swami is very good to you. You like him very much. If he does not do good, you go away. No, that's not faith. See, bhakti, Swami has given a very beautiful example. First, Markata bhakti. Second, we pipilaka bhakti. Third, vihanga bhakti, he says. Markata bhakti, once you give a fruit, he just takes it, does not eat. He puts it on the right side and jaw, ask for one more. And again, you will give, take one more, put it in the mouth, again one more. No satisfaction. So people are, some devotees are like that, according to Swami. Whatever I give, still they are not satisfied. Now, vihanga bhakti. Vihanga means eagle. Eagle flies in the sky, saw a woman carrying food on her head. She, from there, she jumped back with so much of speed. And the moment this woman goes to the left side to another place, she misses. And again, the flies back upstairs, flies sky high. So they are like that. People come to Puttaparthi with so much of enthusiasm and all those things. If the Swami does not see a day or two, then they go and say, they don't come back. That is vihanga bhakti. Pipilaka bhakti. Pipilaka means ant, small ant. When the ant is going there, he gets a smell. Somewhere there is a sugar. She goes there, eats sugar to the fullest extent, carry whatever she wants, and then will come back. She sees another ant, tells her, here is the place, please go. That is called selfless bhakti. Not only you are expanding, you are enjoying and experiencing that bhakti, you tell others also. Though this ant is very small, but the way in which she does sacrifice, you are not doing it. That is called bhakti. This bhakti has been given in so many items are there. But we are human. How did you get into this world? You must know. What is the reason for your birth? First of all, you know, universal consciousness means spiritual energy. The whole Bhagavatam says the creation starts from the energy. That energy, you call it as universal consciousness or spiritual energy or Paramatma, whatever the name you can give it. From that universal consciousness, you must have a sloka, you must have known. Purnamadam, Purnamidam, Purnasya, Purnam. There is sloka. Means total quantity is there, out of which one third of the portion comes out, the balance again becomes full. That is the meaning of that sloka. That is spiritual energy. One which comes out, that energy is unseen, cannot seen, invisible. After sometime it becomes a gas, it becomes liquid, then becomes matter. This matter, one mass. And God, the spiritual energy which is there, universal consciousness, made it into several bits. And each bit, the spiritual energy entered into that. Before that, it was not inanimated. It was not at all movable. Because the spiritual energy entered into every piece, then it started moving. That is called animated matter. that animated matter starting with insects, then two cells, three cells, five cells, like that, an animal, then finally man comes in. That is human. This human, again, according to the Veda, he has to get back to the universal consciousness. How to go? He has no choice. He can't go back in the same place where he came from. Therefore, he prays to God. Oh God, please help me that I have to get back to you. That is, again, you can call it as the bhakti. Then God, from universal consciousness, he comes directly. That is called descendants of God from the universal consciousness. The descendants we call avataram. That avatar purusha comes down, then gives darshan to the human. The human develops bhakti and it does jnana karma in such a way that he reaches God. And then when you reach the bhakti, then you also understand that jnana. What is jnana? I'll come back to jnana. Let us talk about bhakti now. So with that bhakti, he goes nearer to God, nearer to God, nearer to God. And once God is satisfied with him, he takes him back to universal consciousness. That is the purpose of life, according to the scriptures. I'm going to talk about the scriptures, authority is there. Therefore, this bhakti, again, conditional bhakti, unconditional bhakti, there are two kinds of bhakti. If Swami gives, we like it. Swami does not give, no. Swami tests. He says, Swami, what sort of a test you are doing? Why can't you give me the bank? It is somebody's money. The manager sits there. You want loan. He gives 100 pages, fill up all these things, give you that certificate. Then you say, somebody's money. The manager wants to give. You can't, manager cannot give. You have so many details which you have to undergo. And somebody, when that ordinary man, somebody's money, you put so many questions to you. My grace, my money, my wealth, give it to you. He does not ask you for a few questions, few tests, he says. We have to undergo that test. That test only one has to pass that test. The more you pass, the more severe you get it. Swami, unless he is satisfied, then only you say, Vada Navadu. That fellow is he belongs to me. That is the degree we should get it. There's no question of a university degree. University degree, so many degrees are there. But his degree is my man. Navadu. He belongs to me. He's mine. That's what this I and you are one, according to the God, Jesus. Jesus, what did he say? I am the messenger of God, I am the son of God, and I and Father are the same. Same thing here. I and you are one. That is called Advaitam. There is no question of duality there. The duality does not come in. Therefore, from that bhakti, so you in order to see that bhakti, sometimes it comes out. It should not come out. Therefore, bhajana, then the Gayatri Mantra, Yaga, all this is continuity, so that you will not forget. Continuity. The continuity. The college, the exam, weekly exam, then monthly exam, quarterly exam, half yearly exam, annual exam, so many exams are there. In my continuity, so that you will not forget the subject. So similarly here, once you pass the right exam, then afterwards you read the books are no more necessary. That books are no more necessary, you are graduated. But now, you are still a student. You are still a student. So where are we? We are still a student. Are you become a devotee? No. The devotee is certificate. That certificate is not given. So we are past becoming a devotee, but I am a student. We usually say, he's a very senior devotee, very exalted devotee, ardent devotee, all are imaginary feelings. We are not at all come to that level of devotion. What do you mean by devotion again? One-pointed attention means under all circumstances, the form and the name that has given to you, that is you're given that to your heart should not change. You know what happened? Shivaratri, good to puja for Shiva. Shri Ramanami, puja to Sri Rama. Then Kanda Shasti for Kanda. Then Guru Purnima. Then Gokulashtami. You keep on changing form for every function. No, you should not change it. You celebrate those functions, but in the heart, don't give your heart, don't change the name, don't change the form to anybody else. You have other things. Even God says change it, you should not. That's what Swami says. Hinduko, Nanendu tells God to know, he says, why are you contemplating on me? What is your Kuladevata? He says, You think of Kuladevata? I said, Swami, I have no Kuladevata. Why? With your family? Yes, my family goes to Tirupati. But here, when I came here, I enjoyed you. I don't want to go. I want your form only. That is the devotion you should have. Only once you are eligible, then you wanted me to write that Bhagavata, 14,400 slokas. It took 7 years for me to write. That is 72 months I wrote it, physically writing, meaning, and so much of thesis. But unfortunately, during 3 years, 3 years ago, there is a heavy rain. The water comes to my house about 5 feet high. I thought most of the books have gone into that. Only few only left there. So I'm telling you, that is out of love. Now when love comes to you, you see no limits. You get so much of power to write. Otherwise, do you think I would have written so many books, 14,400 slokas? I mean, I must have written more than 1,000, 2,000 pages. How can it be possible? Because of love. That is the quality of love. So love means sacrifice. And you don't feel it is a sacrifice. For others, it may look like sacrifice. For you, you are enjoying it. Because you want only Swami to be, you see the child, for example, the child becomes 9 months old or 10 months old, your mother takes it face to face and sings some bhajan, some songs, smiles it. When the child smiles back at the mother, you imagine the feeling of the mother. Mother gets almost tears, blissful tears. The child is looking at me, child is smiling at me. That is the purpose of bhakti. If Swami smiles at you, lifts your his eyebrows towards you, then means he accepts your love. That means sacrifice. Everything belongs to him, nothing belongs to you. That's why you should keep this world, like everything belongs to him. Have that feeling. Bhakti means, again, I'm telling you, sacrifice. And that sacrifice is also, you must do it with love. Because I want to get something, therefore I am sacrificing. It's not correct. You are doing out of your own love. Nobody told you to do sacrifice. But your sacrifice is not to please Bhagavan. So that pleasing is most important. When Swami smiles at you, that's an acknowledgement for your devotion. So therefore, a bhakti means it keeps on changing. Mind is so bad, it always converts you into the bad thing. That is the reason why continuity. So many people, you say with Tukaram, take Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, take Meera, take the Purandara Das, Kanakadas, all these people, you know, they keep on, take our own Madras, Bhadrachala, Tyagaraja, Saint Tyagaraja. What happened to Tyagaraja? He was so much attached to Rama, and his brother took the Rama statue, put it in the river, Kaveri River. He did not brave his brother. He went in search of idols. Finally, he got it. So, we do know we lost it, so we forget about it. No, he did not forget. So, that is called love. Love means, unless you achieve, you keep on working. That is called sadhana again. That sadhana comes to you, uninterrupted effort for you to achieve that point. That is your love. Love means, again, I'm telling you, bhakti means sacrifice. First thing you must sacrifice. Then what happened? God also has given another 7 items for that. That is, Nirham bhavam means opposite to ego, egolessness. When bhakti comes, automatically you get egolessness. When you get egolessness, next is bhagavat bhavam. You see God in everybody. Again, because you see God in everybody, this is possible only in our organization. Okay? Sairam to you. Hello, Sairam Rajesh, how are you? So that Sairam, who is Sairam? It is in his body, in his Atma. That is called Sairam. We address God in him. That is called Bhagavad Bhava. Because these two, you get Prema Bhava. You love. Love people. Swami, how much he said, love people. After love people, then only you are eligible to do seva. According to Swami, say, oh, you are coming to seva. What is the use of seva? Unless you have these three, you can't get seva. Result of seva, you cannot get it. Seva. Then, prashanti bhava. During that seva, you get lot of problems, lot of mistakes, lot of misfortunes. Keep prashanti bhava. Keep always calm, quiet. Prashanti bhava, number 5. Number 6 is going to kshama bhava. patience and tolerance, and lastly, Tyagabhava. These seven qualities, you have it, then your bhakti matures it. When bhakti matures it, then you get it to in the enjoying his presence in you. What is dhyana mean? You are experiencing God in every place. You see God in everything. You experience God in every place. Everything. See God in everything. When that feeling comes in, when dhyana comes. But some people, when dhyana comes, they think we know everything. That kind of a superiority complex in people. That we should not. Always, bhakti always makes you humble. Dhyana sometimes gives you superiority complex. Here is an example I'll give. There is a king called Ambarisha in Ayodhya. He was the king. And only his descendants is Lord Rama. That talk of before Lord Rama. Ambarisha was, there is a family in his country. So the sage said, the Purohit said, you must do some puja. Watch by day's puja. You should not take food. Just take prasadam. And the 45th day after puja is over, you can have your normal food. He said, okay, you're doing. On the 45th day, Durvasa came. And the king was very happy. My lord, please come. We finish this in another 1 or 2 hours. We are going to finish the puja. We'll have lunch together. So he went there to Sarayu River to have his bath. But meanwhile, the puja is over and Murtam is coming. And so he said, you eat something. No, I cannot eat because I'm waiting for Duras Mahaman to eat. They said, Baba, at least eat some portion. Otherwise, you know, again, you have to do puja for another 45 days. Okay, and you took one spoon. And Durvasa saw, you call me for lunch and you are eating lunch without me. It is insult. So I am cursing you, no? You took some curse. One particular devil, something came to it to swallow him. And what Ambarisha did, closed his eyes, Narayana, 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 Narayana. Narayana's Vishnu Chakra came to the head of Durvasa Mahamuni. Durvasa Mahamuni got up, oh my God, he ran away to Brahma. Brahma said, what can I do? I did not send to go. Shiva is known as Ashudosha. Ashudosha means he gives freely all bones. Go and ask him. So he went to Ishwara. He said, I did not send. Go. Vishnu says, I did not send. What happened? No, Swami, your chakra is coming to my head. I did not send. Oh, but you know, Durvasa is always there to protect my devotees. It goes without my knowledge to serve the devotee, to help the devotees. So you go back to the devotee where you got this problem. So he comes back to the devotee, falls at the feet of Ambarisha. Ambarisha, my God, no, you are so great, you should not fall. What happened? Here is chakra coming to my head. Then, no, I will go only stand in front of the chakra. Then the chakra comes to him, it becomes a garland. What is the moral of the story? Bhakti wins over jnana. Jnana, as long as it is arrogance, you suffer. So jnana means you must always keep quiet. The more you know, the more you should be humble. Ravana was an educated man, philosopher. Then Hiranyakashipu was a philosopher. Then what happened? Superiority complex. Because of superiority complex, they forget all the rules and regulations. They're all right, we can manage. So they do it. But there are some people like Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Paramahamsa Yogananda, Kanchi Periyava, then Vallalar, then Ramana Maharshi. All these people, they are realized people, practically jnana, but they keep quiet. They keep quiet. They're enjoying themselves. Even like Buddha, Jain, all these people, they're jnana's people. But we go to the jnana, they're enjoying. But at the same jnana, we have Hiranyakashipu and we got Ravana, but they took it in another way. That is the reason why bhakti and jnana, if you have that jnana without arrogance, without the seven, all your prarabdha karma would be over, sanchita karma will be empty, sanchita karma will be empty. So that with that empty, then you go. That is the reason why Swami also say, when you're coming to Sudaram, when you're coming to Prashanthi Nilayam, don't come as an individual, as a managing director, as this, as that. No, you are coming with nothing. Sarvopadi Vinir Muktam. Remove everything, your so-called designations, everything outside. Tat Parvatyena Nirmalam. Come to me, Nirmal, with purified heart. Come sit down. Urshikesa, Seva. Urshikesa, Lord of the senses. Urshikesa, yourself. Do Seva to me. Sing some bhajan. Okay, do some Seva. Bhakti Uchate. That kind of a bhakti is supposed to be exemplary. So the whole purpose of life, according to what they call synthesis, whatever you may call it. Ultimately, the moment you are born, the ultimately you have to get back to the original position where the children. No child, no son accepted the reception, they went back and closed the door. So Dasaratha could not see the child. After 10 days, Vishwamitra comes to the ashram, to the court and asks Dasaratha, please send Rama because he has to work for me. He says, no, sir, I did not see, I'll come to you. No, I don't want you, I want only Rama. Rama, I did not see, he did not come to the court hall at all for 10 days. You tell him that I have come. So sent word, Rama comes, Lakshmana comes. And Rama, Vishwamitra knew that Rama is not just ordinary son of Dasaratha, he is Lord Narayana. He goes near to him, my respectful obeisances, Narayana. I can't do it in the presence of people here. They will think that I'm mad. You are only 16-year-old boy doing it. Why you are not coming? Is there any role for me in your acting, your drama? Yes. Then he gets back. Rama, why you did not come for all these 10 days? This is the question he asked. And he says, I have a lot of doubts in my life. Oh, you went for a physical tour. What happened? See, I went to a village. There, a girl was crying, some of her 7-year-old girl. Why is she crying? I was watching. She said, Mommy, I want this doll, particular doll. She cried for 5 minutes, and then the mother could not resist. All right, here is the doll, and keep quiet. After some time, she said, no, I want another doll. She started crying. The mother got angry and beat her. She started more crying. So I went to the next village. A teenager girl, she was about to get married. So he's afraid whether she's going to marry an old man or a young man. Old man, what happened? Why should I leave? She started worrying herself. And went to the next village. There they got married. They have no children. They are worried about it. What to do? What sort of yagna you should do? So went to another house, another village. They got 5 daughters, no son at all. For the family, we must have one son. What to do? They are crying. Went to another village, only sons. We want one Lakshmi, one Guru Lakshmi, one daughter should be there. Please help me. They are crying. I went to another village, one businessman. He was suddenly so much angry. See, myself and the opposite friend get together. Now he has got a 4-story building. I am still in the guest house. I am still in the hut. I must work hard to get money. He is getting depression and agitated. Another one old man. He used to see the eye of the eagle. When the eye could not see the eye of the eagle, he thinks that he is going to die soon. So he is getting worried. Wherever I go, I told you, these people are worrying for some reason or other. I have not come across a person who is happy. Do you think is there any possibility for a man to remove all your worries and depressions and make happy? This is my doubt. Then Vasishtha says, Vishwamitra, after listening, see, Vishwamitra, Vasishtha is your Kula Guru, your Asthana Guru. He has replied. So Vasishtha Guru says, Paurushena Prayatnena Yojaniya Subhepati. Then Vishwamitra, my Guruji, he talks for 6 hours. And you are given answer in 6 seconds. Limited day, he does not know. He is Lord Narayana. You wanted people to understand. Let the world understand. So therefore, you talk for a while. He talked about 1 week, giving last 12 stories. So, Paurush explanation. Paurushena Prayatnena Yojaniya Subhepati means a man with Paurusham, with human efforts, uninterrupted efforts, Prayatnena, and with all hardcore, you must continue. Then if you do that, Yojaniya, even the auspiciousness which is far away from him, not only achieves it, you also become the master of the auspiciousness. So the master of auspiciousness is in you. You can change your karma. You can change your prarabdha karma. You can get your liberation just now. This is what this teaches. Just imagine 6,000 years ago. Swami also comes in a very simplest way. Why you bother about all those things? You keep me in your heart. You love me. Then I'll take you back home. See how fortunate we are to have him in this. See, that's why, somebody asks, who is Rama, who is Krishna? We have not seen them. Rama lived for himself. Rama lived and showed how a man should live. He showed Satya and Dharma to follow under all circumstances. He never failed. That's why Rama is known as Uttama Dharmika. Now Krishna is always full of love, full of love. And for him, Satya Dharma is above all those things. So he is Shanti and Prema. For Swami, all these four is there. And he has enormous patience. We are people with a litigate minded, small minded, always quarreling, always spiting on somebody. These things, he just removes everything with complete patience. Prashanti Nilayam. What do you mean by Prashanti Nilayam? Pra means eternal. Shanti, peace. A place where eternal peace is there. We are going there. When you go to Prasadil, what happens? You get peace. With the peace mind, then you can easily understand what is love, what is dana, what is bhakti, what is liberation. That's why let us make it a point whether Swami physically present or not is not the question. You must go to Prasadil compulsorily. Compulsorily leave. Stay there for a week. You know, let me tell you, in New York, I was talking. In Manhattan, there is a Bharati Vidya Bhavan building. So one lady, an American lady, came. And he says, I am not at all happy, I am depressed. I asked her, why? No, whenever I used to go to Puttaparthi, I am so happy, you know, she says. Why? See, there is a blissful peace. In New York, I am sitting in New York, I got money, I got everything, I have no peace. Then I'm better I go and settle down in American woman, rich woman, middle-aged woman. She talks about it. She is able to understand the significance of Prashanti Nilayam. And we, the Indians, why? Why? Swami says, example gives a very good example. You see the light? In Telugu, we call Deepastambam, light. When you put the light, put the wick there, and then light that wick, the light, the whole room is lighted. But exactly below the lamp, dark. You people are in the dark, he says. We mean, so you talk about local people. See how it is. So we have to be brighten ourselves. Therefore, this bhakti and jnana is inevitable. We have to practice. If you want to call yourself a human. If you do not want to call yourself a human, it's up to you. You can do whatever you want. So be a human first. Okay? Sai Ram, Sai Ram.
Let us now have a question answer session. Uncle, we have got many questions across the world. Let us get into one by one. The first question which one of the Sai devotees has asked is, among karma, bhakti and jnana, which marga is the easiest way to reach God? Or all these three are one, are different, are interrelated? So this is the question as first one of the devotees asked.
See, there is no question of thinking which marga is the easiest way. It is for you to choose. There is a university, there are various degrees are there. Physics, chemistry, botany, zoology, mathematics and so on. Which one do you like? You take that particular course. Even if somebody takes physics, you take chemistry, somebody takes mathematics, but all the three degrees are given by one person called vice chancellor. Then they won't mention BSc within bracket mathematics, within bracket physics, they won't mention. So similarly, it's for you to choose. There is no question of asking, what do I choose? When you're joining the college, they won't ask you. You want chemistry or physics, you want logic, or it's for you to choose. You choose whichever you like. But once you choose it, love. Love means sacrifice to get this. Just because somebody said, I did it wrong, you heartily love it. So you should love.
So we can say, like, bhakti is the easiest way.
Everything is easy. It depends upon which one you choose. Which one do you like? எது சாப்பிட்டாலும் உடம்பு சக்தி வருதுப்பா. வாட் எவர் யூ டேக் யூ கெட் எனர்ஜி. ஸோ ஐ மே டேக் அனதர் ஃபுட், யூ மே டேக் அனதர் சப்பாத்தி, ஐ மே டேக் ரைஸ், சம்மன் டேக் மில்லட், சம்மன் டேக் ஸ்பின்வா. எவ்ரி திங் கிவ்ஸ் எனர்ஜி, இஸ் இட் கரெக்ட்? Your choice. There is God in the only in our Vedic religion, it is for man to choose. Whereas other religions founded by individual, you must do this, you must do that. But in Vedic culture, there is no compulsion for you to choose. That is the difference between Vedic culture, Sanatana Dharma, and other religions.
We are getting into a second question. Uncle, is good karma performed in this lifetime alone a guarantee for liberation? Does it negate all previous bad karmas of all previous lives and lead to liberation? Is there any way we can seek liberation in this lifetime itself?
First of all, we are born only to get liberation. That much you know. But just because you do good karma, you are getting liberation, that's not correct. It is something like this. Just because you passed in the weekly test in the college, do you get a degree? No, you have to pass through the annual exam. You have a weekly test, monthly test, quarterly test, half-yearly test, annual test. Then only degree comes in. So you must continue. That good karma, you must keep on continuing. So there is no question, negate all previous bad karma. Don't forget about all those. Don't think of all these things. Don't think of whether it's negative. Whether that means you are thinking about all those things, you are selfish. You are doing it for the sake of something else. No, you must do it for the sake of loving God. If you do that love for the sake of loving God, for the sake of make God happy, I am doing this. Not for my karma is deleted or I am going to get liberation. Forget about all those things. Mamekam Sharanam Raja, according to Bhagavad Gita. Forget about all these things, man. Be with me, be at my feet. That's what it is. Therefore, whether you, first of all, you do not think whether I get liberation, question mark, wrong. It is the duty. God, college, will I get a degree? That's the reason why you joined the college.
You have to study.
You have to sell it. So forget about every weekly test. Will I get a degree? Will I get a degree? Means you won't get a degree at all. Forget about it. Keep on writing exam one by one. Automatically you get it. You concentrate on the subject, not on the degree. Degree automatically will get it.
Next thing is the third. One of the devotees has asked, Bhagavan Krishna in Bhagavad Gita says, do your karma and offer the result of the karma to God, which he describes as karma yoga. How can we constantly remind ourselves and practice this karma vala tyaga? So how is it that practically possible?
Swami has given the answers for it. About a part-time devotee, a full-time devotee, last time I said, any action that you do, I'll give another example. A parent makes the son to study in a college. They are not rich people. Be careful, you have to get a degree. You got nothing else but to get a degree. Don't meet people, don't go to friends, clubs, this and that. So his aim is to get a degree, nothing else but a degree. So he joined in the hostel. Why are you joining the hostel? Get a degree. Why are you eating food? You get a degree. Why are you bathing? You are getting a degree. Nothing else but degree. So you please have that kind of feeling. Whether will I get it? Question mark means you are doubting. Became a doubting Thomas. Don't do that. Don't think of whether I can get it or not. It is for him to choose. You will certainly get it. It may be delayed, but cannot be denied. Reaction for your good action, there has to be reaction. There is no question of reaction. It is there. But wait. Don't unnecessarily get worried about it. Forget about all those things. Swami Bhagavan Krishna says, that is for Arjuna. Arjuna was so depressed. And he did not want to fight at the time. So he gives him nine shlokas only he teaches to him. And Vyasa has written 720 to elaborate so that people can understand. There he says, you do your duty. Leave it to me. I know how to take care of it, he said. That's what he teaches. Now for us also, what we should do? Do your duty. What do you mean by do your duty? Do it with love. Do it with love of God, and if at all any result is there, no, not for me. Let the result go to God. For example, you are working in the office. and you go to Bombay or Delhi, and you are doing something for the company. The company, they are, those people are very pleased. They want to honor you. They want to present a memento to you. You must say, Baba, I am only an employee. You must do it for management, not for me. You give me the gift, I give to my management, my boss. You say, no, gift is for me. I am taking home means, what does it mean? You are a traitor. Correct? So, Swami has given all the powers to you, and you think you are enjoying it. No, it's for the Lord. It's for the Lord. If you have that kind of a feeling, automatically he'll take care of you. He'll take care of you. He will not allow you to go down.
Okay. Now the fourth question. When a person meets failure after failure, and in his life thinking that it is merely because of his past karma, he is highly demotivated and becomes inactive, doing nothing to uplift himself, thus not doing justice to his family or society. I think due to this COVID situation, many people feel this as often. How should we overcome this situation?
See, you have a bank account. Today you debited 10,000 rupees. And there, tomorrow you are giving a check for 1,000 rupees to somebody. That check presented, it got dishonored. And you go to the bank, I paid 10,000 rupees yesterday. And I give only 1,000 rupees. So you should have passed the check and give a balance of 9,000 rupees credit to my account. The manager says, Mr. So-and-so, your opening balance minus 15,000 rupees. How can I honor your check for 1,000? Out of 15,000 rupees, you paid only 10,000. Another 5,000 rupees due. You pay that 5,000 rupees due, then give extra another 1,000 rupees, then issue check, then I'll pass it. He is called Prarabdha Karma. He will pass it. God will certainly honor you, provided you Prarabdha Karma brings down to zero. How to bring down to zero? As I told you in my story, in my speech, you keep on doing good karmas. When you're doing good karmas, Lord is pleased with you and he gives you protection, I told you. Protection means the results of the Prarabdha Karma, you need not have to experience it. He takes care of it. Gives you for the sake of for duty, one scratch is there on your body, but not the bones. So therefore, you must always do your duty, offer everything to God,
The thing is, failure after failure, that is the...
Yeah, good. That means God is testing you. Have that patience. Failure after failure means testing you. For God, there is no question of saturation point for a test. How many tests we have done, for us? Test so much. Example, just give. You'll be surprised. Dr. Bhagavatam, I'm talking about 1970s. Whether Krishnamurti should be here in Prasanthalam or I should be here. If he's here, I'm going out. You decide. Now, what do you say for it? Bhagavatam says, sir, police, sir. Go, sir. Where to go? It's a test. You come away from Prasanthalam, that's all. You have gone to hell. See, do you have to wait? You have to wait? For 45 days, I waited for that. Then afterwards, this happened in the month of October. I don't want to give. So all the example, probably you will be knowing it.
They will.
See, in October 14th or something, Swami called me. Hey, you take care of canteen for the birthday. So you come on November 14th. This is your team, ABCDFGH. All of you come on November 14th. I'll explain to you what to do. So we went away. We came back to our places. Jogarao telephoned to me. Hey, what are you doing, man? You are in charge of the canteen. You got a team. 7 or 8 members are there. What are we doing? No, sir. Swami said that come on 14th of November. What is coming on 14th of November? Everything is production. Ground level. You have to construct a shed. You have to do electricity, power. It's not that easy. Come now. And he's next to come. So we telephoned to our friend and said, let us go. These people from Bangalore and put up other, they went nearer. We only said day for only one day, day for yesterday. I said, why didn't you come back again? He said, so Krishnamurti wanted me to come. How do you like it? సో ఈ వాంటే స్వామి వాకింగ్ వరంట కృష్ణమూర్తి వచ్చినారా, కృష్ణమూర్తి వచ్చినారా, కృష్ణమూర్తి చేస్తాం ఎవరు ఎవరు వాట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఏ ఫార్చ్యూన్ యూ హ్యావ్ యువర్ నేమ్ హెస్ బీన్ మెన్షన్ సో మెనీ టైమ్స్ సో ఐ కేమ్ బ్యాక్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్ స్వామి మెన్షన్ లైక్ యూ ఐ ఆల్సో ఫీల్ సర్ప్రైజ్ దెన్ స్వామి కేమ్ అవుట్ విత్ స్మైలింగ్ ఫేస్ వచ్చినావా రా సో హిస్ యాక్టింగ్ ఈజ్ సో బ్యూటిఫుల్ వెన్ యూ వెంట ఇన్ భగవంత నువ్వు రా భగవంత ఆల్సో భగవంత నౌ యూ డిసైడ్ వెదర్ హీ షుడ్ బి హియర్ ఆర్ ఐ షుడ్ బి హియర్ పుట్టపర్తి If he is here, I am going out. What is this? I'll open your mouth. Our Bhagavad, go, sir. Go, sir. Where to go? So I came back and sat with our people, our group. What did Swami say? Hey, Swami asked me. Sir, Swami loves you, sir. Is this called love? Yes, Swami loves you, sir. You are very lucky. Then we came back. November 14th, we came. So every batch has to study Varanda. Indula Shah was in charge of World Council President. Hey, Krishnamurti, where is your batch? You are so-and-so, all they come? Yes. You sit there, Varanda. No, sir, no, uncle. I am not at all in the... Swami asked me to get out. All those things I don't know, man. Your name is there, approved by Swami. That's all I know. Go on, sir. Okay, I went and sat down. So Swami was talking about everything and he started giving badges. He came to me, no badge, you went to others. I told our people, say, no badge for me. So you work, they say, I'll be behind. Sir, come, sir, he plays with you, he wants somebody to play. Then, all right. So, in those days, there is no gas. So we brought firewood, but for our friends, Larry, there's firewood. Put a heat. Swami, every day used to come, see what is going on. Swami is coming, I'm not supposed to show my face. I went and sat under the wood. Swami stood there. Ekkada tisaru, where did you make this wood? How many tons are there? And if you give you they're sitting inside. If somebody comes one wood, everything will fall out of my foot, my head. Then afterwards, we said, what, sir? Where did he go, sir? You sure are supposed to answer all the questions, not me, sir. Those people. Aray, Swami, he loves you. You don't know. Then, one particular day, especially on November 19th, I have a fever. We bought one espresso coffee machine. That is new. Suppose if it's new in Puttaparthi, it makes lots of sound, you know, puss. So coffee, 25 paisa, we are giving it. I was having a fever at that time. Then Sevajal came. Sir, Swami is calling you, sir. So I started running. There, you don't know where, Rupak Chankoti, there are whole students. He's not there, no. He was him. So the moment I entered the room, why did you call him, sir? Swami seated in the state. Why did you come? Sir, see, November 22nd, our drama is there. Jesus of Nazareth drama. And we told you last month, Michelle, you were supposed to bring makeup, dress, and this. Yes, all those things will come. When will it come? On 21st morning, it will be here. With makeup man, with the dress man, everybody will be here on 21st. You came, sir. Officer, ask him to go, man. So, shoot. Hey, Udra. Hey, Udra. He took one vibhuti. But he doesn't want to look at me. He is a fear. He gave it to me. Okay. Just imagine. Then on that 22nd morning makeup, they said we started the morning after. Uncle, you got to be here because we don't know that makeup, your makeup man, dress man, they're all travel people. You are about to explain. Okay. Swami, the Swami came to the dressing room. Swami is coming in. I went to the bathroom and closed the door. And they were explaining after, sir, uncle, where did you go, uncle? Swami is playing with you. He wants somebody to play. What? I say, sir, okay. Then I was telling him, sir, we has to be like this. And there are so many things. I give instructions to those people, follow what they hear. Again, after 10 minutes, again came. Swami, what to do? So there was a big mat was there. So I went to the corner, sat down, covered the mat. Uncle, you are doing too much. This is not the way you should do. You should stand here and ask. Baba, you should not see. He says, you get out of the way. Stop seeing me. You don't know, sir. You are still a child. You must play. You must play. You also play. I'm playing. Then birthday was over. 24th, 25th already started batch by batch and giving them instructions. So 26th, chanting committee batch. You are a chanting committee. I told you, you go, I said, I'm not coming. No, sir, you are the leader, you are supposed to be there. No, the four, we won't go unless you come. So what I said was, I stand near the door only. If not, he asked me to get out, I should come out. I was standing near the door. All these people are very close to him. I was far away. So he was talking and everything and all this. And he started giving vibhuti packets to everybody. He comes to me. I wasn't bending like this, you know. So he put his hands like this. Vibhuti. I looked at him. Tisko. Tisko means take it. Rape pilistan. Tomorrow I'll come. So tomorrow myself and wife went. Soundary will shoot. நான் மாட்டு வின்னல ஜோகராவ் மாட்டு வின்னல ஏம் சாமி வேறு ஜோகராவ் சாமி ஹோல் வேர்ல்டு இஸ் யூ நீக்கு அர்த்தம் வீடு அர்த்தம் கல்வி புதிலர் அடிக்கு வாட்டி மீன் தட் மீன் ஜோகர் ஆசஸ் டு கம் நெக்ஸ்ட் டே தட் இஸ் ராங் ஸோ ஃபார் தட் திஸ் 40 டேஸ் அந்த ஏய் 45 நாள் எட்டுவே புரிஞ்சுதா அவள் ஸ்பெண்ட் 40 டேஸ் 200 by 120 சாமி தெரியுதுரா தெரியுதுரா அதெல்லாம் ஒட்டி இல்லை I'll serve you food. He started serving you. This is good. This is very good for you. This is love. You have to express all the, you have to go through every test. But pass. Don't run away. Just because he is bagging you left and right. No, take it. So therefore, that is a test. If you want to get liberation, with Swami is there, what else do you require, man? Let him, the more he bangs you, the more he loves you. That's all the answer. Okay?
The next question is, can God remove the effects of karma that man has done?
Yes. He has got every right. He is the creator. You are asking the creator, can I do this, can I do that? Nobody else can do except him. He is the creator of the universe. All our lives are under him, isn't it?
Even though it was bad.
Whether bad or good, he decides. He is the one who has created you. You understand? As I told you, in that matter, spiritual energy got you to eat. Therefore, you are moving. The one the spiritual energy becomes taken out, you are a matter. You are animated matter. You are mass of flesh. Correct? So therefore, he is the one which gives that. He knows everything. He has got everything. 100% it is under his control. But only thing we feel that is not under our control. That shows your supreme ignorance. So better to follow what he says. Whether you like it, don't say I like it or not. Some people say, unless I like it, I won't do it. You are a fool. That's for a man, for God. When God says something, it must be for you. He never says bad for it will be for good for you. So please follow what he says with love.
The next question is, if our past actions determine our present and our present actions determines, that is the seed for our future, what is the role of present in the present?
The present is called, according to Swami, the present is called...
Now we can start.
The present is called, according to Swami, is omnipresent, where past... reaction of the past is present. The reactions of the future also is going to be present here. Therefore, today, omnipresent is the today's present is more important. It contains both past, present, and future. So, therefore, this is very important. So, what you should do, you know, take calmly, calmly and quietly. You whatever the work that has been given to you, do it with love. With love. Love means no arrogance, no ego. That's called love. With this ego and arrogance is there, there is not love. So do it with love. Everything. Swami gives so much of importance for prema, 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 prema. What are we being? We don't show. Every action you are determined. Forget about yes, this is correct. Past results are there with you now, and future results also are going to be with you. It depends upon your action. But these things, we give result to Swami. Swami wanted me to do, I will do. I won't do, I won't do. Example I just now gave you, just because I listened to Bhagavan Jogarao, What is the mistake, the punishment I had it? Keep it. Had I followed the Swami's principle, nothing would have happened. So that is the example. So follow his example. He knows how to shape you.
But how was those days?
The Gopikas have even thinking, they involve themselves so intensely, only Krishna is the only world they had. They never had any other thought due to that. So that thing, that was the ultimate thing. I think Swami has given more on bhakti part. So how they intensely love God.
In the case of Rama, Nama never gave liberation to people except two. One is Jatayu, other is Avari. Now, Gopikas, if you must know, read the Lord of Ramayana and also Bhagavatam. There are so many varieties of Gopikas. Just don't use the word Gopikas. So many varieties. Jalandhara Gopikas, Ayodhyapani Gopikas, Mithilapani Gopikas, Pulinda Gopikas, Rishidupa Gopikas. So many. All have come. For all these people, Rama said, Tathastu, Tathastu, Tathastu. That means, I appreciate your work, your love for him, but I am not giving liberation next time. So all these people came to Krishna. So they came with a good marks, first class mark. They get a seat in the college. Like that, everybody came. And especially Pulinda Gopikar, they are illiterate people, tribal people. But they used to eat animals, drink. But they used to respect rishis. So the rishis were running. They said, why are you running? What happened? Any lions are there, tigers, we are there to kill. No, God has come. So they are running. What did they also came? They also came and saw Swami Rama was seated there, Rama Lakshmana Sita was seated there. These rishis came, touched their feet, put their lotus feet on their thigh, started washing the mud, everything, soil, and they put on their soil. So these Gopikas, these Pulidas, then afterwards, Swami, how could you, we also have that same opportunity? Yes, you should not drink, you should not eat, you should not kill meat, you should not kill. You have stand on your own leg. That's all? Yes, that's all. From now on, we are going to do it like this. And whatever, you go to find. So when they die, they are so happy. I'm going to God. See? That is faith. Faith. We cry because somebody is dying. That man also dies. I'm going to go. He also cries. But here, you're so happy. All other people, what man, you're so lucky to go now. Why are we going to God? Imagine, they are Gopikas. They came to Gopikas again, the same place, and there was a famine at that time. The subjects of Kamsa. Kamsa said, go there, Sailajagiri, there is Sailajagiri mountain is there. There are a lot of fruits, vegetables are there. You go there, I'll come and help you. Then next to that Sailajagiri, go over the Nigiri. So these people thought, go over the Nigiri, saw Swami, 10-year-old boy, playing with cows and all this. What is beauty and all those things. So they came, followed him. They came to Vrindavan. So these people did not want to go back. So they went to each and every village, each and every house. We'll give some work, we'll do work. Put easy on nothing else. So they wanted to see Krishna. They wanted to spend their time with Krishna. See, that is because the previous Janma's karma attracted. And Krishna was watching everything. So one day, on April 5th, then April 1st we call Pangani, in Tamil we call Pangani 15th, in the English April 1st. He started playing the flute. When he started playing the flute, these Gopikas who were working here and there, they stopped everything, ran towards him. When they ran towards him and stopped there about 20 feet, they're afraid to go front. Their language is a tribal language. Here is the Sanskrit. What to do? Then what Krishna did? He puts his hand like this. Speak. And they said, oh, Amurhuchena, oh, lotus eyed one. The way you knew Pulinda Gopika, we never did anything. They were able to talk in Sanskrit. Sabai Mahana Krishna, Father Vindayor. They said, oh, Krishna, we are given the heart in our heart for your lotus feet. So, Sabai Mahana Krishna, Father Vindayor, he said, that is, we are given a place for your lotus feet in my heart. Whereas in the case of Anjaneya, Anjaneya gave his form, Rama's form. Full form of Rama in his heart. So see the difference between Gopikas and Anjaneya. Anjaneya is a, you know, the Sanskrit authority. He's a Sanskrit grammar, ninth Sanskrit grammarian. He's the one who wrote grammar. Such a knowledgeable person. Very Jnana. He's got Bhakti and Jnana both. But Jnana fooled him too. Last time, if you know the end of the story, Anjaneya, he fights with Rama. That is a different story. Let us not bring it here. We'll talk about something later on. So here, the Bhakti, Savai Mahana Krishna Padara Vidyur. Vachasmi Vaikuntha Gunana Varname. Whenever we talk about you, nothing else. Karau, Krishna Chetra Marjana, these hands is only to serve you and your devotees. Kasha Rachuta Sat Katrade, all listen to you. Here is only listen to you. That is Bhakti. So naturally, Gopikas are in his heart. So therefore, nobody can beat the Bhakti of Bhakti of Gopikas. You ask the Gopikas, so I give the answer.
Next question, the final question, uncle. Pencil tells its tale. It says, I cannot write on my own. I require sharpening from time to time to bring out the best of my abilities. Just giving an example as a pencil, and I commit mistakes, but do erase them. My life is still, there is a lead in the frame. When I complete, I have pages to guide for our generations. So can we thus define this as Niskama Karma? Just as I'm giving an example.
No, pencil, you say, it cannot write on my own. Similarly, here also, we cannot progress on our own without a guru. So whereas pencil, the guru is the one who writes. But that fellow is a bad guy, he writes so many things, bad things. Then afterwards, he requires a rubber to erase it. Whereas a man, if he goes to a spiritual guru, nothing will happen to him. Therefore, the pencil will keep on reducing. By that time, it is useful for writing the complete answer. So similarly, your life also, as it keeps on ending, you must complete it and be ready to leave. So similarly, when you are committing mistakes, you commit mistakes because you are not properly trained by a guru. If you are a guru, you will not commit mistakes because you follow him. Therefore, unlike pencil a thief can write a pencil, an officer can write a pencil, whereas a guru cannot put you in the bad seat. The difference between pencil and a man wants a guru to train him up. Pencil requires a man to write. That particular man, maybe X or Y or Z, may have positive, may have negative. But here, a guru is only positive. So therefore, we are something better than pencil. Pencil 100% depends on somebody, whereas we depend on only on guru. That is the difference between pencil and mind.
I think due to time constraint, I think we are limiting to the minimum number of questions. Hope we will have a lot more discussions to be carried out on this topic. Today, as we all discussed in the earlier, we learnt all the inner significance of karma, bhakti and jnana in a more practical way. As uncle has initially stated that everybody knows about the definition, but how to practically understand? So that is the most important aspects we all as a human to understand. Because going through the scriptures, it's not that easy to learn all these aspects in an easier way. So he has given every aspects in a meticulous way. That too, due to the situation, we all involve ourselves into karma, bhakti and jnana, and we need a practical approach. That's what we need to understand. Due to this materialistic world, we are not supposed to involve ourselves in day-to-day's life. We should ultimately understand God. There are various processes which we need to undergo. Definitely, only in Sai organization has given a more pathways to attain bhakti, an easier way to reach God. So I think when you compare any other organization, it has not given in a much infinite way. So only in this Sai era, it is highly possible, as being as a normal human, Swami has made to this level to improve us. Hope you all enjoyed the session. Now, the next week, we are going to have a satsang on Saturday, same time, 27th June. We are going to have 7 p.m. on Om Sri Sai Shri Matre Namaha. It's basically a Mother Sai showering the love of 1,000 loving mothers and extolled in Sri Lalita Sahasranamam It has been given by Srimati Rajeshwari ma'am. She was the ex-warden and she was the former lecturer of commerce in Satsai Institute of Higher Learning. Let us involve ourselves in more such satsangs in future. Sai Ram.
स्वस्ति प्रजाभ्य परिपालयन्ता न्यायेन मार्गेण महे महिषाः गो ब्राह्मणेभ्य शुभमस्तु नित्यम् समस्तलोका सुखिनो